All right, guys, welcome back to Mr. Post Frame. Today we're going to start a short series on making a doorway wider. So that's not ideal, but this is a building that we built this spring. It's a 50 by 120. The client wants a wider door here. It would have been obviously more convenient to do that prior to this point, but I agreed to do it for him. So we're going to tackle that today. The first thing I need to do is to put in another footing. So as we go through this, I'll explain to you how I'm going to manage this without messing with the trusses and all that kind of good stuff. But before we get started, if you want to design a barndominium, a shop, garage, reach out to us, design at Mr. Post Frame. Also, if you are a self-builder, check out our Patreon group. It's a group of self-builders where we share different building topics. We do lives. It's a great community. You get to share your build with others, find out how they do their stuff, things they would change. Check that out. But let's go ahead and figure out how we're going to make this door wider. All right, so this door is 10 feet wide and it's 12 feet tall, and they want to make it 2 feet wider. So we do have a header up here where one truss rests on that header, and I do not want to mess with that. So that side of the door is going to stay exactly the way it is, and I will move this side. So the way I've decided to do this is I got to take the metal off. I'm going to measure out where my pier goes for this column. I'm going to put the column in, get it all fastened in, get my headers in. Then I will take this other column out. That way, this roofing system is never unsupported by headers. I think that's the best and easiest way to do this without taking any chance of messing up the roof. So I'm going to go ahead, get started in getting all the trim off this side of the door, getting the metal down where I can access to drill my footing. And we will drill this out, and we're going to pour this one footing with some 5,000 PSI concrete. Typically I use 4,000, but I wanted to get some bag concrete because I can't get it's not cost effective to have a concrete truck come out here for just one. So I got my lift up here, got my skid steer, got my tool trailer, so it's time to get going. All right, guys, so I've taken off what I need to be able to get my skid steer and drill in here to drill this hole. I suppose I could have hand dug this, but that's never easy. And so it was worth me bringing my machine up. And so what I gotta do is I gotta put another post exactly 2 feet over. So I'm just gonna measure from the outside edge of the post over 2 feet, mark it, I'll drill my hole. And then I have my concrete mixer, I brought some water, and then I'll mix this concrete up for this pier, pour it, and leave it be. I got my metal ordered and the new trims that I need, so I'll give this a few days to set up, bring a new column up, and that metal, and then we'll put this all back together. Have this footing poured. If you look right there, it's 2 feet over, so that'll make this 10 foot wide door, 12 foot wide door. So I have some 2x12 headers laying there. So what I will do is when I come back, I'll bring my column. I'll get my column set up, nailed in nice and plumb where I want it. Then I will run a header underneath that 2x12 that's already up there, and it'll butt right up against it, get attached there to the stub column, to this stub column, well, it's going to be a stub column, and then to this actual column. Then I know that that roof load will be supported by this column on this side and that column on that side. So then what I can do, I'll get one on both sides. Then what I can do is I can cut this one out, get these headers removed, put new longer ones in, and I'll probably double up the outside one just so we're good and strong. But step one was to get out here, get this metal and trim all taken off, get these girts off so I could get in here, drill a hole, and then I just poured this one with 5,000 PSI footing mix. So we're good to go. I'm gonna let this set up for a few days. I got the trim, new trim pieces ordered. So when I come back, I'll bring the column, the trim pieces, and my tool trailer, and I should be able to install this, get everything fastened, button up in another day. So probably be a full day to do the rest of it. I will have to take the rest of that metal off above the garage door and probably one piece on the other side so that I can get that header off, get a new one in. But I'm gonna leave it for now because it'll probably be about a week before I get back here. So that's gonna be a wrap on this video of widening a post frame garage door. If you are willing to buy another column, leave a column in place while you pour your other footing. This is something that can be done, I'm not gonna say fairly easy, but it can be done without affecting your roof, taking any chances of it sagging. It's just going to cost you money for another column, another footing, some longer trims, and the time to do it. So as always, you guys, we appreciate you watching. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, share it with your friends, and we'll catch you on the next video.